Hello team. Now let's see the demo of chain of responsibility. This is my first demo on chain of responsibility where I have an interface by name responsibility distributor where I have two methods. One is set next chain and one is share responsibility. This demo is totally about an ATM, how the ATM will give you the currency of 500 rupees, 100 rupees and 2000 rupees. Where in chain of responsibility, my major thing is that I have the responsibility and I have to distribute between my objects. Now, whatever class I have, let me create one class. This class is currency where I have some private integer amount, where I have public currency integer amount, this dot amount, and even I have get amount. Fine. Now, this is my interface and let me go and implement this interface. When I will go and implement this interface, I have to go and write the body of set next chain and share responsibility. In my theoretical video, I have explained that if I have some object, if I have some responsibility, and that responsibility is meant for my object or me as an object, I have all the independence to go and check this. If this is my responsibility or if I have said I have object for 2000 rupees, so here I am going and keep checking that in my if loop. If currency.getAmount is greater than or equal to 2000, then I have written some code here which says, let's say get currency.getAmount divided by 2000. I will have number. Then I will have remainder by modulus of 2000. Then system.outprintln dispense number of 2000 rupees. This much number of amount of rupees I am dispensing. Whatever the remainder I have, if remainder is not equal to 0, then this dot chain dot share responsibility and I am passing new currency and remaining remainder to the next object in my chain. Else, if currency is less than 2000, then this dot chain dot share responsibility and I will pass that currency here. What is this dot chain dot share responsibility is? If I will go to interface, this is the method which will take me to the next object of the chain. If you will go here in set next chain, basically I have responsibility distributor and next chain as a parameter here. Here I am saying this dot chain is equal to next chain. How I am giving this object to the next object, I will explain. Let me go and see the 500 rupees. For 500 rupees, again, I have written down some code similarly. I have write down code and check for 500 rupees and set next chain is equal to this dot chain equals to next chain. And similarly for 100 rupees, I have checked for 100 rupees and this dot chain dot share responsibility to currency. And this is my set next chain method where I said this dot chain is equal to next chain. What this next chain is doing? Let me go to my main method. Here I have public class main. Here I have set private responsibility distributor C1. What is this responsibility distributor? This is my interface. Okay. Now I have given some variable name here. Now I have some public main. I have some constructor here where I will go and initialize the chain. My chain should start from 2000 rupees. Then it should check for 500 rupees and then it checks for 100 rupees. This is the logic that is in hand of developer. Depending on the design and requirement, he will decide that what is the call of the object. Now, my first object here is 2000 rupees. Okay. Now, I have said this is this dot C1. I have C2. I have C3. Now, I said C1 dot next chain. What will the next object? Who will handle the request after C1 is C2 and C1 is C2 is 500 rupees. C2.setNextChain that is C3. This is the last object here. What is this setNext? Let's go and check this back. SetNext said that I will get some variable of responsibility distributor type where I will set this.chain is equal to nextChain. Again go back and check main method. Of 500 rupees where I said c2.setNextChain, I have given the object of next object. I have given the object of next object of my chain. Let's go to public static void main. I have created an object of main class. I have initialized int amount is equal to 0. I have system.out.println enter amount to dispatch. I have taken input from my scanner. Now amount is equal to input.nextInt. If amount is not multiple of 100 rupees, you just said amount should be multiple of rupees 100 and return empty. That is, nothing should process here. I am pointing one point here. This logic is depending on my design. Depending on another requirement, I will have another logic here. Now the main chain of responsibility would come. I will have my ATM dot C1 dot share responsibility. What is my ATM? This is an object of main class. Here I have C1. What is C1? I have private responsibility distributor C1, and of which the first method that I am calling is share responsibility, and I am passing this new currency, the amount that I got here. I am passing it as a parameter of new currency. This is my, I am creating an object of currency and calling this constructor here. You just go and check this currency back here. I am just passing the amount here. Coming back here. What is this share responsibility? Let me go and check this. Share responsibility of 2000 rupees. I will go here. This is my share responsibility, which will get called by the main method here. My ATM.c1.share responsibility. So first is of 2000 rupees. Here I will process for 2000 rupees. After everything that get processed, I will set this dot chain dot share responsibility, and I will pass again new currency and the remainder amount here. What is this dot chain dot share responsibility? I will call in this dot chain. What is this dot chain? From somewhere I am coming and initializing this chain object here. And of that chain, I will call the share responsibility method. What basically I am doing, if you will come here in main method, I am giving objects which will get called. First I said this dot c1. In c1 I pass the object of c2, and in c2 I pass the object of c3. So c1 dot set next, that is 2000 rupees. Set next will come and it will initialize this object next chain, this dot chain here, by object of 500. So this dot chain dot share responsibility is an object. This is an object of 500 rupees, and it will call method of 500 rupees, and it will pass remainder amount there. If condition false, then also in that case it will pass responsibility to 500 rupees. It will come here. It will check whether 500 rupees this and that. After that, I am again calling this dot chain. Here I have private responsibility distributor. Even that I have in my main method also. If you will see my main class, here I have given that for C1. And what is this C1? I have initialized initially to 2000. What is this C2? This is 500 rupees. And what is this C3? 100 rupees. And I have passed that in a chain. So this is the logic of chain of responsibility, where I initialize the object and I will keep them in the chain, that first this object will get called, after this, this object will get called, and after this, this object will get called. When you have called that object by the share responsibility, this logic is in your head. Chain of responsibility design pattern just says that you do your work, and the thing after you have done, you passes that to the another object. You passes that to the another object. And that call is defined in main class. Let us go and run this. It's asking me about, let me pass. Amount should be multiple of 100 rupees. Okay. Let me go and run it again. So to discuss one 2000 rupees note, one 500 rupees note, and 200 rupees note. Let me go and run it again. Let me pass it. 3, 5, 6. So each object performs its function and passes the remaining one to another object. That's much for this video. I have created one more demo of chain of responsibility. Let's see that in another video. Thanks.